the early 20s, and then she left.
Yes.
She was deported, actually, in 1919.
Right.
So she was there for a couple of years and left. And, of course, things were not only chaotic in the first few years, but Emma Goldman was an anarchist. And I don't know how interested you are in anarchists, but anarchists typically don't like socialists. Anarchists typically don't like communists. And Emma Goldman saw very little in the Soviet Union that conformed to her anarchist ideals. It was not there was no attempt to build an anarchist-inspired society. And so she left. And I don't want to go into a whole long thing on Emma Goldman, but eventually, of course, she was banned from the United States. Eventually, she wrote her autobiography. Doubleday and Company published it. And she says, I did some research on this. I don't know, research. I read some stuff about this years ago. She wondered why Doubleday published it. And in fact, Doubleday said, this is such a good book, why don't you write another one? Well, of course, you wrote your memoirs. I mean, what else is there to say? But she did. And she wrote someplace or other, she said, I know that what they're interested in, they're not interested in my anarchist ideas. Mm-hmm. They're interested in my anti-Soviet stuff. Right. That's what they're interested in. John Simon Guggenheim, who was a mining millionaire, multimillionaire, after whom the Guggenheim Museum died, and his wife inherited much of his money. She ended up building Emma Goldman a house on the French Riviera, from which Emma Goldman was able to go in the 1920s and 1930s around the world giving talks. She was actually permitted to do this. She eventually ended up, of course, supporting the Spanish Civil War. But the Spanish Civil War was a conflict in which the anarchist forces were fairly strong, at least, you know, for most of the time. So she supported the anarchists in the Spanish Civil War. But basically, she was used. She permitted herself to be used. This is my take on it.
Right.
She permitted herself to be used as a kind of anti-communist spokesperson. And of course, she set forth her own anarchist ideas, but she knew that this was not really why Sophie Guggenheim was buying her this house and why she was allowed to go on these speaking tours and why Doubleday and Company was publishing her memoirs and many, many copies. So she was used she permitted herself to be used as a kind of anti-communist spokesperson. She was not the only one.